Why do people engage in reflex and habit behaviors when they're being sexually assaulted, or physically assaulted, or attacked in military combat? Why do memories of such experiences tend to be fragmentary and confusing? Because evolution, over millions of years, selected the brains of our ancestors who survived such life-threatening dangers, especially big predators trying to kill and eat them. Thanks to evolution, all of our brains have what neuroscientists call a defense circuitry. Circuitry just means a collection of brain areas that work together to perform certain functions. Scientists understand that our brains have many circuitries, just as there are circuitries inside of our smartphones and computers. You may have heard of the amygdala. That's a key part of our brain's defense circuitry. An important thing about the defense circuitry is that it's always on and always, automatically and outside of awareness, scanning for danger. And the moment an attack is detected, the defense circuitry quickly dominates brain functioning. In fact, the defense circuitry dominates brain functioning in any high-stress situation. It's the defense circuitry that rapidly impairs the rational parts of the brain. And it's the defense circuitry that suddenly shifts the brain to reflex and habit behaviors. For millions of years, our ancestors lived in danger of being attacked by bigger, faster, and stronger predators. For them, the reality was, stop to think and you're lunch. So evolution put that fast and automatic defense circuitry into their brains and into our brains. If we want to understand the most common brain-based behaviors of people during sexual assaults, then we need to understand what happens when that defense circuitry dominates their brains and behaviors. And if we want to understand why memories of sexual assaults, like memories of physical assaults in military combat, are often fragmentary and confusing, then we need to understand the basics of how memory works and how the defense circuitry alters the functioning of the memory circuitry.